Hi everyone, Len Goucher and Gary Hines here, and it's Tuesday, December the 7th. Gary, it's a busy time of year, and a lot's happened in history at this time of year. I guess yesterday was the anniversary of the Halifax explosion, December the 6th, 1917, and our friends from New England came up here and probably saved 10,000 people. I know there was a couple thousand people killed and 10,000 injured, and that figure probably would have been reversed without them. Did you ever go to the tree lighting?
No,
in Boston?
No, I haven't. No.
I've been down there a dozen times or so, and it's an amazing event. That's one of the big things for this province during the Christmas season. Also, today is the anniversary of Pearl Harbor. I thought you'd have that one.
No, that doesn't concern me a whole
60,
lot either.
69 years since that. And my mom and dad's anniversary was yesterday, too, so it was easy to remember the day before Pearl Harbor, 69 years.
Yeah, Len, I kind of like to look off into the future more than back in the past, because looking at the polls this morning, the provincial election looks like we're not that bright in Nova Scotia yet.
Oh, Gary, look, I'll tell you, it's the Christmas season, so hi, folks. I hope everybody's looking forward and everybody's ready for Christmas. Gary Hines and Len Goucher here, and we're going to try to give you a short update on the things that are happening up here at the Dome. Gary, as well, you know what, looking back here, I think I've identified the Christmas Grinch. And anyway, I'll leave it there for the people to have a look at, and we'll leave it at that. It's been an interesting week. We've gone from one Tuesday at a council meeting to another meeting, and hopefully this one will be a little bit more even keeled.
Len, you and I probably have a long list of Grinches we could put up on that behind us here.
Yeah, but that guy that's back there is probably pretty well marked. But anyway, we'll leave it at that, and hope that the Christmas Grinch doesn't show up too many times.
Len, can I jump in here and tell you what I want for Christmas?
Yes.
Well, we have a little project in the community of Waverly where we're trying to save the McDonald's Sports Park after the provincial government failed us. And as a result, we've entered into a contest, and we need the support of the people out there, the viewers out there. I need them to go on the internet and search out waverlycommunity.ca and vote where it says rejuvenate the McDonald's Sports Park. You have to register to vote, but after that you can continue to vote up until December the 15th.
Gary, I'll put that website. It's running right in front of us now.
Well, that's good. That's good. Thanks, Len. But anyway, those of you out there who are interested in helping our community and a project that's vital to the community and that serves the youth as well as the seniors, we need your assistance. So give it a little bit of time and look after that for us.
Gary, is the McDonald's Sports Park the same sports park that was looked after by the Waverly Athletic Association?
It is. That's the one, and it's our group that are doing this. We've revamped the Waverly Amateur Athletic Association. We've got some new young energy, and they've found this Aviva competition that we can actually subscribe to and vote to get some.
Aviva is what, the insurance company?
It is. Yeah.
And so what kind of reward is it now for winning this?
The winner of the category we're in gets $25,000. They pay the top 10 positions. Right now we're in 14th, so we need a little bit of a boost going into the last few days.
Well, I know I voted twice yesterday, so anyway, folks, get in there, and for every email you have, get in there and file a vote for the McDonald's Sports Park. You know, it's a great project. Gary, just getting back now with regard to the Dome, what's been happening over there, and what's the schedule for this week?
Then we've been running straight through with our regular programming, very few cancellations. However, over Christmas, we do have cancellations that people who want to have family parties or birthday parties or just a little get together when their friends are in and so on. We have ice available through December the 26th to the 30th. So if you want to give me a call, I can book you in there for some family time.
Well, that's great. So what do you got planned for Christmas?
Usual. Go to Moncton for a trip the weekend before Christmas and then spend it with my mother. I've been home every Christmas since I was born, so I guess I'm not going to make any exceptions this year.
Brenda's folks are in Moncton?
Brenda's mother's in Moncton, yeah.
Oh, wonderful. Yeah, I know we've got, I know my daughter arrives week Thursday, so we'll be glad to see her from Calgary. They've already had a mess of snow and cold weather.
They did.
Well, you know what? Talking about that, how have we been making out down there? This has been an abnormally mild December. We've had a lot of rain and everything else. How's the ice been at the Dome?
The ice has been excellent. The quality's still there. We've had some humidity. When you get a little bit of rain and overcast, it turns mild, but we can handle that. So, we've had
no problem.
It hasn't affected us. No.
Well, that's amazing. Well, Gary, with Christmas season on us now, if somebody wants to book some ice, I know that they can go to the website. My website here has got a schedule on it, which we try to keep up to speed. But they can also give you a call here at the Dome at 832-0348 or email rockylake@bellalliant.com. Anyway, if they want to book ice, is there any deadline, or is there? I know that we're going to be closed down the 24th, 25th. Are we closed on the 31st on New Year's Eve?
We're closed the 31st. The guys will be coming in to check the rink and check the equipment every day.
Yeah.
But other than that, we're down Christmas Eve day and Christmas, and then we're down again for New Year's and New Year's Eve.
It's great to give the guys. I know that they're one of our greatest resources, our employees over there, Jamie and Peter. So it's good to give them the time off. Gary, getting to the New Year's and beyond New Year's to the 2011. I guess ice time is probably at a premium from the standpoint of our prime time ice.
That's right. The only prime time ice that we will have from now to the end of the season will be a cancellation when a team goes off to another tournament or something. And I try to keep them up the schedule as well as on yours. We keep those up the schedule so people can tell pretty much what's there. I also have a list of people who are on the standby, so I send it as well.
I notice, I'm just looking at the schedule here from here on the back wall, there is some time late evening on Saturdays and Sundays as well?
Yes, Saturday we have a young fellow who booked for 8 till 9, and he's having trouble getting some reliable individuals on his team, but he has 10 guys, and if he could pick up another 10, he would continue scheduling that. So if there's anybody out there looking to play a little bit of pickup hockey with a bunch of good guys, just give me a call here at the rink, and I'll forward it on to Mike, and he can then accommodate you.
I've also put his name and his phone number. It's on the schedule. The schedule page on our website. Anyway, Gary, it's Christmas time, and we're looking forward to a great Christmas. I know that we've got my daughter coming home with her fiance in about another week, and you and Brenda. I hope you have a great Christmas, and our people on our board and all the folks out there. We hope that you have a wonderful, safe Christmas. You didn't comment here, Brenda.
No, other than that, I was just wondering if Santa Claus actually comes to Grumpy Old Men, or if we got a fender as well.
Well, Grumpy Old Men, I don't know. I guess that's you and I, and maybe the new year I'll see some new commentary from the Grumpy Old Men. But anyway, folks, we wish everybody a very, very merry and a very safe Christmas and a happy new year. And don't forget about the Dome. We're here, and anything we can do to help our users and those people that are looking for ice, we'll bend over backwards to try to assist you. From Gary Hines here, Len Gocher, and the staff, we want to wish everybody a Merry Christmas, Happy New Year.
And Len, it is Merry Christmas, and they are Christmas trees.
They are my Christmas trees. Absolutely, they're Christmas trees. And to the folks that celebrate the holiday season through other faces, we wish you all the best, and have a great 2011.